Hello, this is NJ with another Let's Play of Dishonored. Last time, we rescued Emily from the Golden Cats, Benoit's brothel. We spared the two Pendleton brothers just for them to have their head-shaped tongues cut out, and then put in mines to work for the rest of their life. And yes, that is also part of the... Yes, that is the neutralizing, kinder version and fate to just killing them. I was expecting that would be better than having my tongue cut out, but that's just... tongue cut out, head shaved, and then forced to work in a mine in which you usually put your worst enemies in. But hey, that's just me. And Pendleton's pissed at me, but won't give me gold for it later. I know you will. You better. Dear God, look at the detail they put into these guys. And seriously, it's amazing. When I say guys, I mean everyone. Girls too. Look at the hair. Hey. Look at the hair. Hey. No. One. No. Now you're just trying to do this to me, aren't you? Ah. Just the detail is amazing.
Martin's devised our next move. There's a footnote in Campbell's journal that tells us the Lord Regent's mistress sat for a portrait with Sokolov, the painter and royal physician. He'll be able to give us her name. Sokolov lives on Caldwin's Bridge about half the time, out over the river. The catch is that I'm afraid you've got to head out right away while Sokolov is at his apartment on the bridge. Samuel can get you close to the bridge, but you'll have to find Sokolov. Bring him back here intact, and it'll enable us to make our next move. I can't believe what you've done so far. Escaping from Coldridge, taking down the High Overseer, recovering Emily. You make this old military man proud. That's it, then.
And you have no problem with me? Power of the Outsider and everything else? Overseer Martin?
It's amazing how many overseers he's been blackmailing. It really is the key to the Abbey.
Good to know. All that corruption and everything else. Just good to know. And I already have everything from you. So, goodbye! Ah.
I know you. Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later.
Yep. Let's go!
I'm aboard when you're ready.
But I wasn't aboard before? Alright. Let's go to Caldwin's Bridge. Ah, yes. Sorry about that if you heard that. I was just trying not to. Anyway. Okay. Caldwin's Bridge. Bridge of Caldwin. If I remember correctly, there are two saves. First one is 7-3, and next one is 2-9-something. 4-5.
What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Gunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up.
Got it.
Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions, and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know?
You know, Samuel, usually I don't argue with you, but that one I will.
You at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready, Corvo. Assuming, of course, you've taken care of those floodlights.
I will. No. I
understand now. Curfew means ain't no allowed to be just wandering about, except us guards.
Yeah, I know. But if we do see someone, then what? Do we say something? Remind them about curfew?
No, don't remind them. You chase them down, and you give them a severely deadly beating, is what.
Okay, yeah, I got it. No point yelling at
And that's why I do that. And I do that. Well, that's why I actually don't have a moral problem with killing these guards. It's because of that mentality of beating people severely. And that is really scary and really cool.
Attention all citizens. No pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Also, I know in the PC version there's a trick where you're able to just link through this bit here, but they did not put that particular glitch in the Xbox version, either 360 or 1. If you're wondering why I didn't use it, if I don't use it, it could be useful. A lot of the glitches in the PC don't occur here. And personally, that's just fine with me. I've got plenty of tricks on my own. Goodbye. What, really? Oh, whatever. That's it. And once again, why the crossbow, the handheld crossbow with the pyramid, is far mightier than the gun. And also possibly mightier than the sword.
Citizens and visitors to our city.
But I still prefer the sword.
The curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens. No pedestrian movement is allowed along
Caldwin's Bridge during this period.
Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Also, you don't know where it is? It's right there in that room. Which you cannot get through here. It's blocked off from the other side, so what you have to do is you have to go all the way here, jump up, climb, slowly and surely, and methodically, and grab it there. And do this. Then you can do that. However, I do enjoy doing that kind of stuff, I just really do. Now the reason why I'm over here. But while I wait. I didn't really mean to kill him that way. And there's nothing for me to loot there. And I can't even loot him anyway. Okay, so his death was absolutely meaningless. Ah well. Oh dear. I always forget about that Weeper. He's not always here, so that explains why I forget about him once in a while. But that's why. Oh yes, $100 coin. It's like the quarter with George Washington kissing himself. But Lord Regent is dead. And he's doing a lot more than just putting his faces together. Let me tell you.
Allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during
the period. Yeah, I know. It's just a bad joke. I apologize.
Tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Also, I'm sorry if my voice sounds a little bit eh. I'm just trying to keep my saliva back. I have no clue why. Just not physically well right now. It's the beginning of allergy season. So, yeah. Okay. Once again, choices of consequences. Find bone charms. That's right. Use a heart. Use your heart to find stuff that you can then use to kill people with. That's what that kind of stuff is all about.
How is anyone supposed to make a living?
Well now, Mr. Pratchett, even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch. Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good to bait me, officer. But don't worry, I'll be fine. I'll profit. A smart man can come out ahead, even in the time of plague.
Sure, like that Sokolov. He's doing fine. Always a lot of exotic items coming and going from his place. Keeps his place running, at least for now.
Yes, if by exotic you mean foul-smelling as a witch's bottom. The royal physician will be fine, too, until he crosses the wrong man.
Now consider me that wrong man. Wait, did I accidentally shoot him? Nope. He's unconscious. Perfect. Okay, now mind you, I never go through the front door. Or the of this place. Usually, what I do is I just go over their head. I wanted to listen to the conversation for you all. And then I rob him. And after he comes back in. I just go around and do that. Now, this one, it took me a while to find the actual combination. Remember how I said it was 4, 7, 3? Well, let me show you how you get those actual numbers. You get the 4 from... is this one? No. You get the 4 from here. Come on, really? I guess I'm 4. Rewriting tools. Oh, sorry, rewiring. Ah, sorry about that. You get the 3 from here. And you get the 7 from here. I know that's not the specific one that you guys are in, but bear with me here. 4, 7, 3. Like I said, not the order. Not the way it just works. Ah yes, the toilet. The sink. Him packing up. Miles of Morley. All that. Cigar box. Note of reminder to figure out how to actually get in the safe. And everything else. And that's all the useful items in there. A mad survivor.
I swear I have nothing you want. Get back.
And yes, you do.
Rivers change course over many lifetimes.
Oh my god, they messed up. He has blue eyes.
Bridges tumble down.
They're wet in his eyes.
1,000 years ago, there was another city on this spot. The people carved the bones of whales into runes and inscribed them with my mark. Children still find them washed up in the river mud. Anton Sokolov has made a great study of my runes, but he's not special like you are. He wasn't chosen, and he doesn't wear my mark, so he can't unlock their secrets. Sokolov believes there are specific words and acts that can compel me to appear before him. He searches old temples in Pendicia and ruined sub-basements in the flooded district. He performs disgusting rituals beneath the old abbey. But if he really wants to meet me, he could start by being a bit more interesting.
Well, outsider, you do very high standards. Outsider walks amongst us, and outsider walks amongst us. No manner of madness and authority. And everything else. Now, I could go down this way. But for now, I'll head here. Eat this bread. Stuff. Grab that. Back to here. Yep, making sure. Now just head here. Do that. And now we can go through this place and search it for anything that's actually worth something. Oh. This way I can show you all the different possible things that you can get if you're clever enough and willing to steal just about everything and anything.
Charger before your shift when the duty officer brings it by, and the arc pylon won't fry you.
Those things? Even the Willie said. You'll be thankful when Slackjaw's boys come down the street to slit your ricker. It'll be fun to watch them turn to ash. There was a time when we didn't need these things to keep a gang of kids down. I think since the plague hit, none of them expects to live past 20. So why be scared of anything?
The reason you scout is so you don't end up with them.
Anyway, I understand the guards, I understand the Ball Street Gang, I understand them all. And you know what? That's why I have no problem doing what I'm about to do. Come on. No. Rewrite. Oh dear, they took the actual power core out, didn't they? Ah! Usually they don't. Alright, well, just show you the gun. Wait, come on. Oh dear. I don't like it when the alarms go off. No! No! Money! Whatever happens from you. Yes, money. Good. Usually I'm a lot stealthier, but no, I don't see the point of being stealthy, but I'm killing everyone anyway. I hope you understand. Gotta admit one thing about the Ball Street Gang. They're clever in their ability to set people on fire. Oh, before I forget. There, silenced. You have no clue how nice it is just to have that silenced. It's annoying. Then again, you can probably all tell that's annoying. Alright.
He's here!
Yeah, he's dead. Wait, what am I doing?
Where are you?
Alright. Know where you need to concern yourself with. That I can guarantee you. Don't call me scum.
Okay, he got away.
And that's how you kill someone, and then fall. Which, and the amount of usefulness of that move is absolutely zero. And the only reason why I do bother lifting this bridge is just for this. It's just slightly easier. And now...
keep stalking around.
Come on. There we go. Remember I told you about the fault damage bit? There was a place I'd show you exact amount of awesomeness this church has. Well, this is the place. As long as I can actually get up to it. This is close enough, I guess. What? No! No! That is bullpucky! That is farce! No! That is just a farce! I'm sorry, I have to show you guys this. It's a fantastic move and everything else. That's just... that was just a farce. Now some of you might think I might be using the farce the wrong way, but I probably am. I mean, I say farce, a lie, a cheat, and all that. Which, yes, that is part of the definition of farce, though not quite the connotation that the word is used in. No. Like I said, no fall damage taken. I don't want him using this. Not because I don't mind killing more people, but solely because the sound is annoying.
Hey, what? I'll get to the bottom of it. Hey, you with the mat and the hand tank. Listen, I just collect river crossbows. They chased me down, and I had to hide my cat. You help me, and I'll show you where the pearls are. Split them with you.
I know exactly where the pearls are.
Whatever you want. They'll kill me. They'll dump me in the water.
We know you're here. We'll find you. You are here.
The pearls are in there.
He's got his leg.
I'll save him just then. You guys get to see what he does. He ends up training me, of course, but... All right. Well, let's go. What? That wasn't it?
Settled in over here.
No. Where's the power to that again? It's in here, most likely. It usually is.
Hey, I heard that.
Good, I'm glad you can hear that. No. Ha! The alarm didn't go off. Perfect. Seriously, don't tell me I fired or killed the guy and lost the guy or whoever has the key. Come on. Anyway, basically what happens is he takes me this back way. From here we go down here, basically down here. All the way up here to here. And then he tries to kill me here. After getting a drink of water. Pearls are in here. Yeah, funny what happens when you... Oh wow, this has never happened before. The game's been glitched out to have a bolt beam in there. That's cool. But yeah, shoot the guy when he's about to use fire. He sets himself on fire. Cool little trick, eh? Explosive bottles. Not really my style. But anyway, that's just me. No. Once again, roof. I didn't forget anything. Sorry about that. Now let's go. Caldwin's Bridge is more of a speedrun fit, thus this, I believe, is the last section. Besides, of course, Sokolov's place, but that's... Sokolov's place is just incredibly easy to break in. At least the way that I do it. Which is the first way I broke in, which is the only way I really ever break. Bone charm right here. Overseer's music notes. Ancient music. Grab this, grab that. Here's the bathroom. And now to this place. Ah, yes, this place. Now, there are three main ways of getting past this area. One, going all the way over there and shutting that off. And rewriting that. Two, this. Put the box underneath me, turns off the power to that wheel, which then allows me to go over there and shut it off. Or three, the trick that I always do. Just do this. Once they come over the line, kill them. You see, there's nothing really of value over there anyway. The only valuable thing is actually here, which is the bone charm. Which is in this building here.
Is someone around? Help me!
I can help you. And, to be honest, I will. Basically, to help her, you kill the rats. That's all. That's it. Simple, rat killer.
Find a way to keep these rats off me so that I can get out.
There you go. Right person. Come on.
Thank you for help. I thought it was safe. There were rats. So many rats. Completely infested. I know some folks aren't superstitious, but I swear. The rats showed up after a man came through, waving around an amulet of some kind. It looked like it was made of bone. But he's dead now, like the others who were living here.
Ouch. Well, I retook the amulet so you can't rob his corpse. grave robber for the win! And now, that's it. That's this entire section. Sorry, that's why I forgot. I forgot this thing was a section. It's just so short for me. and there's nothing there of actual value. True value. There are some gold bits here and there. Nothing all that great. But now, Cauldron's Bridge, the North End. We're so close to this. And I believe it's, yeah, it is above a portrait. As we also see where this is in the usual way, of course. But I'm going to head up here because there is Zeponcha. Now, of course, just to show you. Wait. And this place blocked off here. Where it actually is, blocked off, just to troll some of you. And then this way, which it leads to here, which then if you do this to here, is how you can get to the control. And now, the other way you can get pretty much everywhere in any. Don't forget your coinage. Go in here.
Thinking again, have you?
No, sir. Not thinking. I was just wondering if Sokolov is testing elixirs on his way. Why is it he always asks for healthy citizens? I mean, if you follow my meaning, sir.
You have no mind for natural philosophy. Obviously, it's because the ones already sick with plague don't live long enough to provide Sokolov with any useful information.
It's just a shame, is all. Like that woman the other day. She was easy to look at. Seemed nice enough. Shame she has to die. I mean, and so horrible-like, too.
Now you listen to me. It's none of our concern, the how or why of things. And if you want your elixir rations, then I suggest you stop your wondering. These are pigs. Pigs for Sokolov's experiments. And pigs mean nothing to me.
And that's why I definitely enjoy
it. Right. I mean, why worry about a couple of disgusting, smelly pigs, you know? All pigs get slaughtered sooner or later. Better if I wonder about those sounds we heard from the warehouse, right? I mean, what was that all about?
That's better. You'll go far, Grayson.
You won't go anywhere. You will not go anywhere.
What is this?
Yes. Right. Really, he survived? Ah, well.
The word! Look at that! Firing! You gotta flee! Clear the line!
Just to show you what happens when you try to blow it up that way. Now, I always kill them.
Why you did this for me, but listen.
And the safe is 294.
Up on what used to be the third floor, you'll see a painting. I used to work there. Behind the painting, there's a safe.
Exit 294.
And the code is 294.
And this is the partially collapsed building. There's the safe. Don't ask me why she said around here when it was right above her. Well, because she's supposed to be over there when she does it. I mean, tells you. Or not. Maybe. Ah, yes. A Lord Regent. Being Lord Regent. 294. Gold! Gold! It's the world! Sorry. And this is how you go here. This gets you here. Now, I can assassinate this guy via arrow to the back of the neck, or with the blade. I think I'll go to the back of the neck. Just so much more efficient. And now, that's it. Sokolov's house, right here. Now, some of you may remember how I kept saying every single time we'd see Griff, that I was never going to buy his surplus formula.
Turn my hopes and energies to Formula 25.
This is why.
In conjunction with a high heat therapy, which came to me most vividly in a dream last night, has great potential, according to the latest celestial alignment. As for test subject 312, after the characteristic sloughing of the skin, she should be dead by mid-morning tomorrow.
Please, sir. Please let me go.
Ah, awake, I see. How are you feeling?
Much. Much worse. Do I have the plague? Please, sir. I don't want to die.
Hush now. No one's going to die. Much improved. The formula I administered to you is working exactly as it should. I cannot let you go yet, because I have not finished with my study. But tomorrow will make all the difference. What? How did you get past all the guards? Your tattoo is quite unusual. It is reminiscent of markings I've studied on cave walls far from the city. Who sent you? Piero? There's no need to be his lap hound. You and I can come to an agreement. One that I'm sure will please you more than anything Piero dreamed up.
You kidding me? It's fantastic.
What is it you want? Money? Elixir against the plague? Now you've got past all the defenses, but I think I can assume if you wanted me dead, well, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Sure.
Everything within my power to give you is yours. You'll just let me go? I can see you are an intelligent man, so you understand there will be repercussions if you should harm me. I am the royal physician, head of the Academy of Natural Philosophy. Stay back! Have you no heart? Please!
If you haven't noticed, I'm holding a heart in my hand, so obviously I have a heart.
I can't say I'm surprised. I knew someone would come eventually, but you're not what I expected. No need for violence.
Yes.
Can be great friends. Will you join me in the drink? Sit. Talk a while.
But it is also great to
discuss your future. Money.
Not all knowledge is gleaned.
Whatever you want. There is much to learn from the stars. Those fluent in their tongue. I could consult my astronomical charts. Is there no reasoning with you?
If only knew how much
before you do anything rash, I think we can come to an agreement. It doesn't matter what they are paying.
Let
I'll have to double it, triple it.
Find company where he can.
Well, money, and money, money, money,
money, money, money, money, money, money, money,
money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money,
money, money, money. I just want to shoot you right between and the crease of your forehead.
Thank you, whoever you are. You kept me in a cage, like an animal. Pain is horrible right now. So I'll just hide in a corner and leave when I'm feeling better.
You're never going to get better. You're going to die. Sorry. I'm going to leave Soapbox here. There's no point in bringing it. However, there is a great point in robbing this place. And actually stealing the information for which I'm actually kidnapped for. Just saying that. Now I can read them later at your leisure, dear viewers. So much gold. Ah, yes. Now, my particular style of grandfather clock, a little too tall, but still quite nice. Wait, I actually have the date, which means today is the last month of the 12th day of the 13th month calendar. Huh. 13th month, not 13th. Wait. Oh yeah, sorry, forgot. This is a high chaos one. I can just kill it. Sorry. Now, What's here is an elevator, a very loud, a very annoying elevator, which is absolutely useless, in my opinion. Especially when you can just go this way.
That might be worth checking out. I've heard something.
Someone!
Now, where's the roof riding to?
Here you are. Fancy
help!
I'll feed your heart to the hounds.
I just love the comedy of it all. No! Not that annoying sound. You craven biscuit eater. You set that off and where? No. And this is the aforementioned guy I hate. You have to be careful where you shoot him, because that thing covers most of him. Except for the legs. Okay, that's never happened before.
Get around him.
Anyway, there's a here's the information I would have actually stolen. Basically, look, who was in the photo? Who was in the painting he painted? I just stole the painting. My opinion is always just the painting. That's the one out here. Annoying. I hate this. I just hate the alarms. They're so annoying. Oh, and there's the elevator. Once again, to me, useless. And this is the entirety of his place. Quite a large place. Honestly. A great hall of dining whenever he has guests that are worth a note. Oh, sorry. Honestly, didn't see ya. A kitchen! A very nice kitchen. A kitchen that is quite kitchen-like. I know, my power description is vast and great with describing a kitchen as kitchen-like. Ha ha ha. Anyway, this is how you usually get up and down this place, after that, you just do that. Knock the two guards out, again, put up here, put up there, then go and steal Sokolov's unconscious body again, and then go. I'm so lucky she's not being one decides to kill and talk to his sleep. But first,
Sokolov here. Excellent progress today. Test subject 312 is declining rapidly. As I theorized, formulas 12 and 17, administered in combination, greatly accelerated the progression of the disease. Interestingly, the respiratory mucosa had erupted and raised pustules, grayish in color, which burst, causing hemorrhaging and pain. I now turn my hopes and energies to Formula 25, which, in conjunction with a high heat therapy, which came to me most vividly in a dream
last night,
has great potential, according to the latest celestial alignment.
Basically, no real science, just dumb luck. He's clever, mind you. Same as Piero, but this world has a very weird relation with the universe itself. You shouldn't say a wrong one, considering the fact that the outsider exists, and all that, and the void, and the fact that magic exists in conjunction with everything else. So I can't mock their paying attention to celestial alignment, but anyway.
Royal physician himself.
You made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off.
I did not make a neat job of it, dude. Yes, let us go. Wait. Help the scavenger. Meh. Don't remember. Don't care. Oh, yeah, no, I already stole from him. Everything else. Alright. Yeah. That, the scavenger was the guy that I couldn't find the key for. That was just going to lead me to the pearls I already stole. Oh, well. This one was within an hour. That's nice. 45 minutes or so. Fantastic. Now to the interrogation. Which we'll probably complete as an hour. And then to the party in which I have stolen invitation for.
The old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock him waking up in the straw of old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. As we all have at that.
Well, I guess prison technically counts as the worst place. It wasn't a clean prison. But I broke out and killed everyone. It was nice.
Well done, Corporal. Well done. I doubt a dozen soldiers could have done it better. Sokolov's knowledge will enable us to strike at the Lord Regent directly, and ultimately help you get your life back. Soon, we won't have to hide in the shadows. The royal physician is brilliant, but he was a fool to protect the Lord Regent. Sokolov gave us the elixir, the war machine. He could have made us a great nation. Now he pays the price for siding with a tyrant. You have my thanks, sir. If you wish to get some sleep, now is a good time.
I'm going to see Emily. You'll understand why. Initially, I thought very little of it. I thought it was just, well, the outsider visiting young Lady Emma in her dreams. Little did I realize that one day, too, in the second game, which you should know by now, obviously, with all the different commercials, that she will have the power of the outsider if she wishes.
Please be as quiet as you can. It took forever for Emily to fall asleep. Poor dear. It's okay, Emily, I'm here. She seems happier when you're here. Though I know you have important things to do. Out there, in the city. Poor Emily. Her childhood is lost. She has become a pawn in the hands of the men. The aliens sweetened with honey. To hide the taste of the river rye. She was bribed with sweet biscuits and ox milk, armed with stories of magic and seafaring.
Oh, yeah.
Please light a candle for me. I get in here and I can't see my mother. I just want a candle. Where is Corvo?
Hold on.
I don't like your eyes. Why are they so black? Stop looking at me.
If you don't know what that specifically is a reference to, the outsider. The boy with black eyes. That is her seeing him in her dreams. And not in that manner. He's actually there, looking. Being creepy.
There's hardly a need to work on table etiquette. She knows it all, even if she chooses not to employ it. She'd rather hold her spoon by the wrong end and pretend it's a sword. Then suddenly she changes and she's all manners, asking for a tea party. I tried to oblige her, but I have little to work with. No proper plates instead of a cloth napkin. I've only the bar rack. Ale mugs instead of teacups. I've asked for things befitting her, but they have their minds on other things. For now, Emily and I decided to make a pretend dinner using paper and little things she's found here and there. On the floor, I suppose. Not right for a princess, but it'll have to do.
Yeah, she's a kid. She'll be fine. When I was her age, I played with dirt. And I loved it. And then I still play with dirt. I still love it. Okay, that was not meant to be reverse. Zoom in. Just in case you thought that. Anyway. Yeah. All right. Like I said, you always want to go check these places.
Be aware that looting of evacuated areas is a serious offense.
And a bone charm is
punished by officers of the watch. Display your pride in Dunwall by respecting the property and rights of others in these trying times and preserving the timeless beauty of our fair city.
And a thumbs vote. And everything else. No. Nothing to steal here? Okay, bye. Is this the same one?
The memoirs, chapter 41, in which I bed two of the Boyle women, and only missed the third by virtue of some inclement weather. It was the month of rain, and to counter the gloom, the Boyle ladies hosted three nights of merriment by invitation only. Lydia was most fetching in lavender pants and a tunic of yellow silk. She was pleased with me from the moment I walked in the door, with my manservant bringing not one but two cases of effervescent wine from the south. In fact, I had come laden with gifts, such that all three Boyle women soon took notice, and they set out to make me more than welcome. We uncorked the wine right away, and as night fell, we... Wallace!
Dang it! Things are about to get really pervy. Come on.
Corvo, can I tell you something?
Yes.
I have a secret retreat nearby that may come in handy if the city watch ever kicks in the doors. It's an abandoned apartment across the street from the bar. I don't think anyone else here knows about it, but I'm guessing I can trust you. The key is stashed under my bunk upstairs. If there's ever trouble, you can go there for safety. I know I will.
Yeah. And now I'm going to go steal that key, so I can steal the bone charm. That's there. I knew about the key, I just can't seem to find it for some reason.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. You are required to boil...
That's why I couldn't find it. I was looking at the wrong end. River.
Anyone who has consumed untreated water must be reported to the watch.
Come on. Alright. Right. Rewiring and coinage. Yay, coin. And the abandoned apartment. More money. Oh, it's just right on the other side. Sorry. No, it was there to begin with. I just missed it. And that's why I still need the heart. Plague resistance. Ubers inflict slightly less damage. Alright, well, reinforced bolts. And spirit water. Everything else currently. Not that useful. Except for Spirited. Potions give you slightly more mana, though I don't have the counterpart that would make it more useful. So for now, I will refrain. Come on. Here we go. Ah, yes. No. Oh, dang it. Remember when that used to kill me? good times. And that's one of the many reasons why you want to get, what's it called, like I did. Agility. Okay. Now I'm going to get another agility just for overall movement. And I'm going to get possession. I'll show you what it's like to possess the first thing that you usually possess. You don't have to be the first thing you possess, but you usually possess it first. Also, remember how I said you get something? The note from Lord Pendleton and 2 gold bars. Worth it. Now the interrogation is tomorrow. You always want to get a good night's sleep, bright and early, brush teeth, and everything else before you start an interrogation. You brushing your teeth, of course. However, you'll also want something of a foul odor in the room to wave in front of the person's nose while you wear a gas mask. After all, interrogation usually requires torture. At least in this game, in this world. Or, if you do it the way I do it, something a little more devious. Waha. I can't laugh, as you can tell. Okay.
Corvo, wake up! You were making funny faces while you were sleeping.
Yes, I was.
I decided to nap here in your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run here.
Very true. You can stay here when you want.
Callista will come get me when she's done with her bath. Thanks, Corvo. It makes me feel better.
You're welcome, of course. Oh yeah, as you can tell, I'm moving a lot faster. Alright. I'm so fast. That's the whatchamacallit stops.
Let us all praise their choice. The dance of investiture will take place without delay.
What?
I hope Sokolov will cooperate. I'd hope to have him paint my portrait again one day. Just me this time.
Got it. Basically, what the announcer was saying was that they are saying that High Overseer Martin is now Overseer Martin is now High Overseer.
I believe you and Corvo knew each other in former days. Unlike you, our friend Corvo knows what loyalty means.
Bah! I am loyal to my inner spirit. You are the one consorting with the most wanted man in the Empire.
It's my belief that Corvo was innocent in the death of the Empress, and the former Prime Master, or the Lord Regent, as he calls himself, is a ruthless tyrant bent on destroying this city, the heart of the Empire.
You are mistaken if you think there's love between me and our Lord Regent. But whatever you intend to do here, I assure you, I am beyond petty scare tactics.
If I don't scare you, Sokolov, perhaps these rats will. Even if they don't carry flames, I've heard of a swarm of rats stripping a child's body to the bone in half a minute. I've heard worse. How long do you think it'll be before you talk? Before you beg to talk?
Rats? Is that the company you keep now, Admiral?
It's the company you keep that interests us, Sokolov. We know you painted a portrait of the Lord Regent's mistress, the very aristocrat who is funding the military with her fortune. She is the key to the Lord Regent's control over the city, and we must have her.
She's funding the entire thing?
Sorry, Admiral. I cannot help you. You're part of this rabble, but I know you have your reasons.
Yes, he does. Yep. All we need is the name of the Lord Regent's mistress. It's very simple.
I elect not to tell you. You will have to force the words from me, and I warn you, my willpower is quite legendary.
Perhaps I can find a bride.
Curious strategy.
Of which I approve.
Don't forget, he is well known for one thing and one thing only. Actually, he's well known for many things, but he's well known for bribery and for liquor. Corvo, upstairs. Don't say very important. Blah, blah, blah. Come find me. Now, if you remember what Tamira was insinuating before, Miss Lydia, think of this now. Sorry, go Or is it Callista? Either way.
I know it looks... I was inventing a new kind of lock. The tumblers, shaped like snowflakes. The truth is, there is no snowflake lock. I was just, you know, looking through the lock.
Which you are able to do with all types of locks and tools. I'd rather you didn't spy on people here, Pero. Who you watch in the bathtub is not of my concern. Yeah, I'd rather not, just in case.
I couldn't bear it if she knew. I know you're a man of honor, and I also know that you can kill me at any time. And for both of these reasons, I apologize.
Well, I'm not going to kill you, Pero.
Beg
no, maybe not.
For your discretion. It's well known that Sokolov is virtually addicted to a rare liquor called King Street Brandy. The taste is revolting, but I happen to have a bottle. However, I am reluctant to give it to you for Sokolov. It cost me quite a lot. It is very expensive stuff, a blend of rare Pendician spices and a drop of whale oil. Would you care to purchase it?
Yeah, sure. Ooh, and stealth boot. Yes, it is so expensive, it is 150. Coins. Something I usually make quite quickly. Oh, yes. So horrifically expensive. And stealth boot 1, stealth boot 2. Get your boots to be stealthy. Reload. Magazine, accuracy, and air. There, all for you. And this is what he was looking at.
Be aware that
now, because I'm doing this the high chaos, and I don't have to worry about any repercussions overall for the storyline and everything else, which you never really have to worry about anyway, since this is a, this is a video game.
And preserving the timeless beauty of our...
Can't you see? I'm about to bathe.
Sorry, Callista. It wasn't my intention to interrupt. Maybe you'd like company? Okay, folks. The response is basically the same either way. But I'm going to do this one because first time to first, even though this is the high chaos ending.
I understand. It was an accident. We have such a hard time maintaining privacy in such a crowded house, don't we?
Okay, that's not completely true. Sorry. Usually what she says is the rat plague, people dying, everything else. Maybe I would have joined you if it wasn't for those things. Maybe I'd let you join me if it wasn't for those things. I welcome your advances, but anywho. So that's pretty much that. And I know I'm heading the wrong way, but I just wanted to do it this way. Wait, is that a... No, never mind. I just love doing that. I really do.
I'll leave it to you. But if you get tired of questioning Sokolov, I'll let you know that his taste for King Street brandy is legendary. I think Piero has a bottle. It might help persuade him. If not, well, call me if it gets entertaining.
You're a very sick man, Pendleton.
I could use a drink.
Perfect timing! I found a bottle of King Street brandy for you. Ooh, you
King
like it.
King Street brandy? I didn't know any more existed. It is an extraordinary gift. I see I'm dealing with men of taste.
It shoves her in his chest.
She was always referred to as Lady Boyle. I painted her to be sure, but I never saw her face or learned her first name. You see, I painted her from behind. I assure you, she still makes a striking portrait. But I do not know which Boyle she is. I was to be introduced to her at a masked ball in her honor this very night. But I will miss that party, it seems.
I won't.
Ball at the Boyle estate. Tonight, the timing is perfect, Corvo. But the Boyles are wealthy and ruthless, so security will be very tight.
Of course, you already have a mask, don't you, Corvo?
He's right. You will be able to mingle with them once you're on the ground. You'll have to find out which of the Boyle women is connected to the Lord Regent and take her out in whatever way you can devise. We're very close now. If you do this tonight, we'll be able to strike at the Lord Regent himself and put Emily on the throne. May the wind favor you.
Thank you. And now, the second I walk out the store, Pendleton will be right there. Told you.
I hear you're off to the Boyle's little bash tonight. I have just a tiny favor I'd like to ask you. Could you give this note to Lord Shaw? You'll know him. A rather brusque man wearing a wolf's mask. In fact, he may be looking for me.
Ah, yes. Now, I'm to kill him specifically, because that's what Pendleton does. He has me kill people.
I knew Sokolov would see reason and tell us what we need to know. He never actually liked the Lord Legion.
No one does, apparently. But basically, I'm killing him. I'll just save it like that. I'll tell you later. But hello, little Emily. Can I actually talk to you? No? Wait, she talks to him, doesn't she? Wait for it. Maybe.
Have you ever been in a sea battle?
Yes.
Of course.
Did you ever see pirates? And did you sink me?
Of course, dozens. Oh, yes. But that's not for young girls to hear about.
But I will be Empress, won't I? And then I'll have to sink lots of enemy ships myself. And that's what Empresses do, mostly, isn't it?
Of course.
I knew it! I read that some pirate ships have witches aboard that can cause storms and make whales do what they want. Is that true?
Yes. Mostly. Maybe we should be quiet now.
Very well.
Aww. And, well, it's 1 hour and 7 minutes, so I will leave it here for all of you. Like if you enjoyed, please subscribe now. Leave a comment section down below and everything else. We'll see you in the next time for the Boyle Party Masquerade, in which I will kill everyone. That's not the party guests, all the guards. I don't kill civilians. I do have that rule. Have a good day and goodbye!